Welcome back to the Florida Folklife Collection podcast series from the Florida Department of State's Division of Library and Information Services. Musical traditions of all kinds are passed down through generations and families. Whether it's a repertoire of songs or a knack for a particular instrument, the family environment fosters unique interpretations and expressions of folk music. Fiddler Julian Goose Culbreath and the Cortez Grand Old Opry exemplify the type of rapport achieved when playing with kin. Cortez is a small commercial fishing village in Manatee County, Florida. It was there that Goose and two of his brothers learned how to play the fiddle from their father, James, a prize-winning contest fiddler. The family gathered each week for a Sunday morning jam session, and the household became known as the Cortez Grand Old Opry among the villagers. Outside the Culbreath household, they also performed at square dances and even had their own radio program in 1949. In addition to traditional Southern fiddle tunes such as the Orange Blossom Special or Arkansas Traveler, Goose was well known for his trick fiddling techniques. These included bowing the fiddle with no hair or wrapping the bow hair around the fiddle, as illustrated on Back Up and Push. The Culbreaths were also known for beating the straws, or fiddle sticks, where a family member tapped rhythm on the fiddle with sticks while Goose played Granny Will Your Dog Bite or Old Joe Clark. Goose Culbreath received the Florida Folk Heritage Award in 1992 in recognition of his unique contributions to fiddling and his willingness to teach other aspiring musicians in his community. Goose was not only a talented musician, but a full-time commercial fisherman, too. The following are recordings of Goose Culbreath performing at the 1987 Florida Folk Festival, accompanied by his son Lloyd and nephew Richard. This was the year they made their debut in White Springs, and they continued performing at the festival almost annually until Goose's death in 2003. These recordings bring some of the Culbreaths' fine playing, once heard only by neighbors and friends lucky enough to attend the Cortez Grand Old Opry, to new appreciative audiences for years to come.
While they get their last bit done, I want to tell you, I went down and visited these folks down in Cortez where they're from, and their house they used to live in is known as the Cortez Grand Old Opry. And I don't know if anyone was to the Maritime area today, you probably heard about this, but they did so much picking over the years down there that the house they lived in got called that locally. And then after they moved out, nobody would move in or tear down the old house. They just kept it there as a museum to their family, the Cortez Grand Old Opry. And one of the reasons is that Goose's father was a fine, fine fiddler who originally was from up here in Hamilton County. So he's lucky enough to have passed down to him a great fiddling tradition. And then he carries it on in the next generations of Culbreaths that we have here, his son Lloyd and his nephew Richard. So we're going to hear some fine picking from the Cortez Grand Old Opry.
First number we're going to try to do for you is Alabama Jubilee. See Deacon Jones when he rattles his bones. Old Parson Brown running round like a clown. Old Aunt Jemima, she's past 83. Shot and I'm full of pep. Watch your step, watch your step. Old one-legged Joe running round on his sore toe. Threw away his crutch and hollered, hey, let her go. Oh, honey, hail, hail. The gang's all here for the Alabama Jubilee. Thank you. Our next number is the Orange Blossom Special. Our next number will be Down Yonder. Our next number will be Billy in the Lowground. We're going to do a specialty number that Elk Goose does. He'll be playing part of this song with a bow with no hair on it. He learned to play that some years ago. And he'll be playing part of it with the hair over the bow, or over the fiddle, pardon me, with the bow under. It was reminiscent of an organ sound.
A little bit of back up and push.
He's fiddling with his hairs there. I'll play an old Spanish tune that my father taught me years ago, and he entitled it Spanish Fandango. Mm-hmm.
One of the old ways of playing fiddle years and years and years ago, they didn't have any accompaniment. So they had to bring straws, cut out little reeds, made kind of like a drum effect. And they tuned their fiddles up and beat the straws on the strings. And Lloyd's going to play the straws now while his dad plays the fiddle. And I'm just going to sit here and watch him. What do you think? He can't find your straws.
If we get these fiddles mixed up every now and then, we don't know which one's in what.
They're all tuned different.
They're all tuned different. This one's tuned up in the two bass strings up high. That's for the old-time fiddle playing. My dad used to call it corded strings. I don't know why you're really...
That was called Granny with your dog bite. No, child, no.
That's what I was going to tell him. But Dad used to play part of it, and he'd sing that part. Granny with your dog bite. No, child, no.
And next song is Old Joe Clark. I know most of you heard that song before.
Told me not to stomp my foot so hard, so I was kind of messing me up. You get happy, you know. You go stomp your feet. He said, "Don't do that; it messes me up." Well, it was messing me up, but not doing it.
The next song is Cindy.
In the same key.
Way down where the orange tree tree grow.